Let's say that we have a system and we don't have any operating system and we want to write a program in assembly which could create some animation for us. For that, we want to install something called QMU, which is a machine emulator to emulate a machine for us. If I say sudo apt-get install and then QMU system-x86 and hit enter, we could install this. I have already installed it, which is a machine emulator. But before we start writing assembly code, I want to explain about some important definitions that how booting starts. When we power on our computer, the CPU would jump to some place in read-only memory or RAM called BIOS. The BIOS instructions would get executed one by one, and the main job or task of that BIOS is to look at the first sector in the hard disk. Hard disk is comprises of different blocks of data, each of which could contain 512 bytes. So the BIOS would look at the first 512 bytes and load it in the memory if the last two bytes are 0x55 and 0xAA. And it would load it in the memory. These 512 bytes is usually called the bootloader and or kernel loader, and the job of that is to load the kernel and pass the control to the operating system. An operating system would act as a interface between the processes and the hardware, and everything begins like you have it. Now, what we are going to do is to write that bootloader, but instead of giving the task to that bootloader or the kernel loader, which is its other name, we would want to write our assembly code, which could create some animation for us. In this case, we would write a program which is in no need of any operating system. With that in mind, I create my file with the name of animation.asm. Also, when we start our computer, it would be in a mode called real mode or real addressing mode. As the name suggests, this says that you have access to all the memory locations, and also you would be in the 16-bit mode. So what we are going to do is to say bits 16 as the first line of code, which is for the NASM assembler. Then I say start to create a label. And but before that, what we are going to do, because we want to use the QEMU and just execute this file using that and somehow pretending that this is actually the bootloader, so that the BIOS would see it as a valid bootloader, we would want to create the last two bytes as 0x55 and then 0xAA. So what DB does is that it is something for the assembler. The NASM assembler would look at these two bytes and says, well, this I should add the 0x55 and 0xAA at the last two bytes. Now we should complete that with our file with 510 bytes, right? So what we are going to do in here is to say that dollar in assembly means that the address of the current location. So what I want to do is to use the times command and say times 510 minus dollar sign. Well, in this case, 510 would be all the size of the file except these last two bytes, right? And 510 minus the address of the current location, and I want to say db0 to say that any size this file has, I want to just put zeros until we reach the 510. But the thing is that this dollar sign would be just an address. So I would say minus dollar dollar, which means that the address of the beginning of the section. For example, let's say anything that we write from here to here would be 60 bytes, right? So this command says 510 minus 60 would be equal to 450. So put all the 450 bytes zeros, and then 510 plus 2 bytes would be 512. Therefore, the BIOS would see it as a 512 bytes with the last two bytes at 055 and AA. Therefore, it would be a valid bootloader and it would boot it into the RAM and the instructions would get executed. But the instruction that we have in here is not to load a kernel, is to create animation using assembly. That's what we promised. So we create a label called start, and then in order for us to do that, we would look at all the things that we have access to, all the interrupt table. This is the Ralph Brown interrupt list, which is all the interrupt that we could work with. The one that we are interested in is interrupt number 10. If you go to the Wikipedia page of this interrupt, it says that it is it's shorthand for BIOS interrupt call. And if we look, it is everything that we need regarding the video. So you see, I have clicked on some of these things. Let me actually bring it in here so that you could see. I have clicked on some of these things because I just read the description and decide that what I should do. The first one is set the video mode. So I should click on that before everything we do. We should just change the mode to video mode, right? It says the AH should be loaded with the value of 00H and AL with a desired video mode. We could see all the video modes in here, like 0H, 04H, 5H. We could, for example, go with 07H in here. So what I want to do is to first load the AH with 00H, right? So I say move AH with 0H or 0 or 00H. All of them are the same. Then I want to say move AL with 07H. It was the thing that we said you want to use, right? Just look at these specifications and decide what you want. After that, I just call the interrupt by saying int 10H. So after the video mode has been set, I want to write a pixel, right? So if we read all these descriptions, we get to 0CH, which is write a graphics pixel. I click on that, go in there, and it says, well, fill the AH with 0CH. When you call int 10H, it would look at the AH. If it is 0CH, it knows that a pixel should be written. The color of the pixel would be by looking at the AL register. And if we look at all different colors, every color would be would have a number. For example, light green, what you want to go with, has the color of A in hex representation. And also it would look at the CX and DX for column and row, and the pixel would be drawn on the screen. So what you say is that move AH with the value of 0CH, move BH, it was right, BH as the page number to 0, then move the pixel color, move AL with 0AH, and move the CX, which is for the column, to, let's say, 5, and move DX, which is for the row, to, again, let's say, 5, and finally, int 10H. And in here, I want to create an infinite loop by saying jump $ to jump the current location. And if I go to, if I want to, well, I say nazem dash f bin animation that nazem to convert it to bin, because you don't have any operating system to have a specific suffix or extension. So I hit enter, and now we use the QMU. But before that, if I say ls dash la and animation dot bin, we see that the size of the file is 512 bytes. If I say xxd and then animation dot bin, we see that this is the whole file. Some of the first bytes are the instructions that we put, and the rest is zero until we reach the last two bytes, which are 55 and AA. Now we use the QMU and animation.bin. I hit enter, and well, we should have the a pixel in the green color. I think it's the problem is with the, since the cursor in here is in here, I think we have a problem with the, let me have a look again. The problem is with the AL register, which we set it to 07H. If we have a look, the problem is with the, with this one, I think, the VGA. Let me choose another one, which I tested before, 13H. So I want to say 13H, save it, exit, assemble it, and execute it. Now we have a pixel right here, which is a green, but this is not what we promised. We want to create animation, right? So I would look at the animation.nasm again, and I would create a label called color, but before that I want to use another register called di and move the value of 1 in that. And then what I want to do is to change the value of cx to di and this to 1, and in here I would want to say increment the di and then jump to color and remove this line. So what we are doing is that we put the value of 1 inside di register, and then for the column I'm putting the register di, so 1 would be in the cx. After this has been finished and we have a pixel on the row 1 column 1, di would be incremented, and this would jump here, and this would be repeated this time with the column of 2 and row 1, and then column 3 row 1, and this would be this would just keep going until we have all of it as green. So I just assemble it again and execute it, and if you look, we have some kind of animation from top to bottom. Now you could work with the numbers again. For example, let's now have a different number. Let me just open it again, and this time what you are going to do is to also change the row to di, so that both of them would be row and column would be 1, both of them would be 2, both of them would be 3, and this would go on and on until we reach the ending point, and then it would be repeated again. So if you look, I think you could make sense of how these things work. If I hit now you see we have a beautiful animation in here. This is going one instruction after the other, one pixel after the other, but the thing is that it's so fast that we are seeing it as animation. Now this is what is done usually, for example, in gaming and in Atari games, how we used to just send pixels to the television and it would just put pixels and different colors on the, or change the different colors, different pixels colors to what we wanted. So again, if I execute it one more time, you see we have a pretty animation. Now you might get some ideas. For example, let's say you want to just put a pixel and create different random numbers, that how you want to the row and the column to be changing, so that this one pixel would be changing inside all of the screen. Or let's say that you want to create a shape of a human or something like that, and you want it you want it to run towards the right. So if you want it to run towards the right section, you would just change the row. Or if you want it to jump, you would change the, let's say, the column. So everything just depends on how you change the row and column and how you write your program. But there aren't any other instruction that I think you need to create any kind of animation that you want. Also pay attention that everything that you need to do is in this single interrupt in this page. Now I think that's it for this lecture. If you liked it, please let me know in the comment section, that we could create a game in the next week.